Hello, hello, peoples. We're here this time with another guide on blade and sole for ball driving. In this video, I'll be explaining my thought process on why I chose to turn this style this way instead of the other way, why I chose to drive the ball like this, and the simple mistakes that I made during this ball driving session. So actually, if you notice, the mistakes is very easy to make. Okay, so without further ado, let's just start the video. So I usually start at the bottom. It doesn't matter if you want to start on in any direction, just my personal preference. I like to see the boss this way, be sexy this way. Alright, so stay closest to the boss because you'll give up the buff soon enough. Okay, so once you get the buff, first thing you want to see, hole 1 or hole 2. As you can see just now in the corner, it comes from hole 2. So once the ball passes the dial, I'll be heading there to rotate it, like so. There. Then I'll head back to the boss and DPS it. Right. Next again, ball 2 would be 2 or 3. It comes from hole 2 again. As you can see just now, it comes from hole 2. Alright. Once I get the buff, I'm in no hurry to rotate this because the third ball would be from either 3 or 4. So this is basically like leisure time. Alright. Here is my first mistake. As you can see, the third ball came from hole 3 instead of hole 3. So meaning one pot here would be filled. What I could have done better was to rotate this dial to the right because there are two empty fan pots here. So that's a small minor mistake, it's not major. Okay, so what I want to do next is to rotate this, the third dial, towards the next empty fan pot. Okay, the last ball, the fourth ball, would be coming from either pot 4 or pot 1. Okay, in this way, this time it works out for me, comes from hole 1. So this dial here would now be optimal. Because another thing you want to know is you want to fill up the holes on the rack first. Okay. So fifth ball comes from hole number 2. You want to try to keep track of the balls. Okay. So here, the next ball, the sixth ball, would be either from hole number 3 or number 4. Either hole number 2 or hole number 3. So what I just did was to rotate this to the left so that if it comes up from hole 2, it enters the empty fan pot. So this is one long road. And now I'm heading to rotate down number 3 towards the left as well. So if it spawns from hole 3, it will take one long road. For example, if I didn't rotate this to the left, it would take like two long roads, because you see, if it comes from hole 2, it comes down like this, goes like this, then goes like this. This is not optimal. So I rotate it this way, and here I'll be heading to rotate it this one to the left as well. Okay, so now either hole 2 or hole 3, right? So I'm checking. Okay, it came from hole 2. Okay, so hole 2, what I want to do now is to either rotate this to the optimal position. Okay, free time, optimal position. Next, I want to rotate this downwards because the only empty ones are at the cooling fans at pot 4. Okay, so this ball here comes from pot 4. The 7th ball comes from pot 4. Okay, so now down number 3 is no longer in use because the last ball would be from either hole 1 or hole 2. But I cannot preemptively turn this because, as you can see, the ball was coming from hole 4 and the arrow is facing this way. Okay, this is the first mistake here. You let it bounce, you let the ball bounce back and forth. Sometimes it can't be helped, but try to avoid this. So once I've said that, here I go, I walk around, I preemptively set the dials to their optimum position for the next round. As you can see, left, up, right. this one facing bottom, done. Optimum position. So you have to do nothing now and just DPS the boss. Okay, so 8 boss driven, done. Now phase 2 comes, same thing, first ball comes from hole 1 or 2. As you can see just now, it was from hole 2 again. There, rotate it. Next, 2 or 3, 2 again. I think I've made the same mistake again where I point it downwards instead of the left. It doesn't really affect much. It's just a small matter. Yeah, I did the same mistake again. Okay, so next would be 3 or 4. I would check those holes later. Okay, it comes from 4. So what I want to do now is after I take the buff, immediately rotate this one to the left. Okay, so the 4th ball, 1 or 4, came out from 1. The 5th ball would be 1 or 2, so I want to rotate this one. Okay, 1 or 2. Okay. So it came out from 2. So it came out from... the 5th ball came out from 2. So the 6th ball would be either from 2 or 3. So you, as you can see, once it go past, I want to immediately rotate this downward because 2 or 3, right? So if it comes up from 2, it hits down. If it comes up from 3, it hits down. Alright, comes up from 3. So next ball would be 3 or 4. So this one would be list of... okay. Here is a very minor mistake. It might make you make the ball bounce back one or twice. As you can see here, let me go back for a bit. Okay. Instead of heading down to down number 3 and wait for it to immediately rotate the, down to the left, I chose to rotate this, which is wrong. This is not important anymore. This is important. As you can see, as I hit there, I realized my mistake. I stopped immediately and hit downwards because the 7th ball, the current one now is 6, it's traveling, I think it just passed the down. The 7th ball would be coming from 3 or 4 and my buff is running out soon. From experience, you'll notice how long, how many downs you can turn with your class, and I realized that my buff was running out soon, very soon. So I made the mistake of coming here instead of waiting down here. So as you can see, instead of just staying here and rotating it towards up top, I immediately rush back bottom. Okay. So, okay. Instead of heading to the boss to DPS, I should have just waited at the dark. Because once it passed, I would be immediately able to turn it. So as you can see, I made the mistake too late. Okay, I failed to turn the down. But no worries. Just head back, take the buff. Alright, I lucked out. The 7th ball came from hole number 4. Okay? There. So as you can see, I almost made the same mistake again, whereby I wanted to set this to the optimal position instead of focusing on the main point here. So, but luckily I didn't make it. So once it passed, I immediately hit downwards there. Because the last ball would be from either hole 4 or 1. Okay, once I've seen the last ball at hole 1, I know it's safe. That down number 2, down number 3, down number 4 is safe to pre-adjust it back to the optimal position. Okay, so you'll be seeing, I'll be doing it as you can see here. This will be facing top, and I chose to ignore this because as you are more confident with ball driving, you'll notice the small mistakes, you'll be able to predict, you'll be able to judge which downs are more important. Okay, so now phase 3 has started. So as you can see just now, the first ball, right, okay, the first ball came from hole 1, that means at phase 2 and phase 4, it's on opposite direction. So ball number 1 and 3 will spawn together. As you can see, ball number 3 just entered. So what you want to do, once they enter, rotate it to the next empty fan pot. Next would be 2 and 4. As you can see, 2 and 4. You are in a... you have a longer time period where you are able to hit the boss during phase 3 and 4. Because the next boss after 2 and 4 would be 1 and 3 again. So I'm in no rush to rotate down number 2 and 4. I'm just like waiting for the buff. I'm in no rush. I'm relaxed. I'm calm. Alright. So you see the ball, 1 and 3. So it was 1, 3, 2, 4, 1, 3. So I got the buff, rotate it. Alright. So now, you have two options. Okay, option 1 is to head back and help your party to DPS the boss. Option 2 is to preemptively set the dials to their optimal position for phase number 4. But as you can see, it's already in their optimal position. Dial number 1 facing to the left, dial number 3 facing to the right, whereby it takes only one turn to towards the next closest fan pot opening. So I'm able to DPS the boss. So as you can see, that's what I'll be doing. Alright, phase number 4 will begin. So see, Acrimor is preparing for a shower of heat sparks. I lost my buff, that's why I'm staying super close to him. Alright, it came from 1 and 3 again. So stay closest to him, okay, get the buff, hit down and rotate. Alright, so rotated, done. So you don't have to care about the dials on number 1 and 3 really, because it's already set in the position and it's in the final phase. Now, just one last thing to do, rotate dial number 2 and 4 towards the empty fan pots, and done. You can focus, or you can forget about ball driving after this. Alright. So if you notice, how that I stood on near the dial instead of on it. You see here, I stood at the side. So when I decided to leave, I won't proc it again. So there, all four phases completed. So now you are just free to DPS the boss. After four phases, there will be no more ball to generate. So if you are melee DPS after four phases, you can come in. You can come closer to the boss. As a ball driver, you can not stay under him anymore if you want to. Okay. And now, that's it. You have completed all four phases. So, if there's anything unclear about the ball driving phases, you can ask me down in the comment section. My name is Riz. Thank you for watching.